In this video, we are discussing load data from files into peak tables. So what is the respective command? So load data from disk into peak tables. So to load data from HDFS file, we need to use the load command. So the command will be load. It will take the data and split it by delimiter and store as a given schema. So depending upon the given schema, the data will be stored considering the delimiter for the splitting purpose. The load syntax will be this. So the command syntax will be like this. So variable name is equal to load input path, then using function as schema. So this is the syntax for the load command. The function area, we can choose among peak storage, you can go for bin storage method, you can go for JSON loader, text loader, and in this way. And to see the table data, we need to use the dump operator. So dump operator will display the current content of the table. So note will be there that we should start our Hadoop at first before issuing all these commands. So I think for the better understanding, let us go for one practical demonstration to clear this concept that how these commands can be executed in the pig environment. At first, we shall start Hadoop. So Ctrl Alt T to initiate one new terminal here. So to start Hadoop, we should type $Hadoop _ install all in capital letters /sbin/start-all.sh. So this is a shell program which is supposed to get executed to start Hadoop on our system. Now to check whether Hadoop is executing properly or not, we are executing the command JPS, and you can find that node manager, name node, resource manager, secondary name node and data node, all the processes are executing. Now we shall initiate our GUI interface of Hadoop. So we are opening our browser. In the URL, we are typing localhost, localhost colon 50070 slash. You see, the name node related information is coming here. All the name node related information, they are coming. So Hadoop is operating fine. You can go for utilities, you can go for browse the file system, and all the default folders and the files are coming here. So that indicates that my Hadoop is executing perfectly. It has got loaded and initiated into the memory. Now we shall show you how to run pig on our system. So we are going to open one terminal. So Ctrl Alt T, there is a shortcut. And to open a pig to use the local data, in that case the command will be pig minus x local. That means it can access the local data of the Ubuntu Linux. But if I want to access the Hadoop data from the SDFS, I shall issue only pig here. So you see, at the end we have got the grunt shell here. So now we shall go for, so this is a grunt shell. So at first we're having one data file, and from the data file we shall load our data onto a pig table. So let us open another terminal here. So here we are having one data file which is there like this one. So under this GUI of this SDFS, we are going for this Hadoop my files from the root of this Hadoop. We are having this Hadoop my files. Under this we are having student_info.csv. So let us see that what is the current content of it. What is the current content? So we shall go for SDFS, DFS, SDFS, DFS minus cat. So that is the Hadoop root, then Hadoop my files, Hadoop my files, and then student_info.csv. You can find that the current content of the file is this one. That is here we are having 5 rows are there. Amit Electronics Kolkata, Dinesh Computer Science Chennai. In this way we are having 5 rows, and this is the current content. We shall fetch this content onto the pig table. So how to do that one? I'm just closing this terminal. So this is our grunt shell.
So we shall open, we shall create one pick table, that is the table say student. So student is equal to load. I can write this load in capital letters also. We can go for this Hadoop. So what is the path here? So we shall go for this Hadoop. My files, M and F. M and F, these two letters will be in the capital. Then the file name is student info. The file name is student info.csv. So the file name with the path has been completed. So I shall close this single quote. Then we shall go for this using pig storage, P capital and storage S capital. So pig storage. So I should have this one as comma should be enclosed within single quotes. And then we shall go for as name. The first field we have the name, name. That is a card array. Then we shall go for the second one. That is a major. That will be of the type of card array. Then you shall go for this city. That will be of the type of card array. So I've given three field names, name, major, and the city. So I'm going for enter. So student is equal to student is a big table going to get created. Is equal to load, and then we're having this Hadoop my file. Let me check once whether it is file or files. Yes, it is Hadoop my files, that is. So let us go for this Hadoop my files. Then we're having slash student underscore info dot csv. That is the name of the file should be kept within the single quotes using pig storage P and S capital. And then within bracket comma has to be enclosed within single quotes as name card array comma major. That is a card array and the city that is our card array. So I'm pressing enter here. So I think it has got created. So to see the table description, we can go for describe. We can go for describe, then table name, that is a student, pick table name. So we can have this name of the type of card array, major of the type of card array, city of the type of card array. We can also write this describe in capital letters. That will also work. Okay. Now I want to see what is the current content of the pick table student. So I shall go for this dump and student. Dump student, and then I shall give the semicolon. So in the grunt shell, we are running all these queries in the grunt shell. Yes, we are having all this data which has been fetched onto this. It has been fetched onto this pick table, that is our student. So it has got fetched. Now we can limit the output. If I want to see only the three tuples in the output, then we can use in this way. I want to see only the three tuples in the output. In that case, I shall go for say limit. Say I'm writing this one as LMT is equal to, we can go for this limit student 3. We can go for this limit student. Student is a pick table name and 3. Now if you go for this dump, limit, you can see the output that we're having only the Amit, Dinesh and the Kushal tuples here. Amit, Dinesh and Kushal. So here also we can make this one, say I'm changing this one. If I write this query in the command in this capital letter, then also it will work. So if I take this one as 4, so limit student 4. Now if I go for this dump LMT, there is a limit, you can find that we're getting only the 4 tuples are getting printed out of 5. So in this way, we have shown you that how to create a pick table and how to see the description of the table using the describe command, and how to see the content of the table using the dump command, and how to see partial portion of the table using the limit command. Thanks for watching this video.